Hello, how are you? I hope you are all really good. I'm really good, yes? Okay, today we are going to watch a video, yes? And we are going to use our students' books, yes? So take your students' books and a pen or a pencil. And at the end of the lesson, you can play Kahoot, finally, yes? So take your cell phone so you can play at the end of the lesson. Yes? Well, now I'm going to share with you a video. Yes, we are going to watch, yes, a video. Are you ready? Yes? Okay, let's start. Okay, watch this video carefully. Yes? Okay, let's go.
Of October at last. It's my birthday.
Your birthday? It's our birthday.
Okay. Hooray! It's our birthday. Later.
The cake is finished.
It's great.
Listen. Their friends are here. Come on.
I think green's my favourite colour.
Chris, don't touch the cake.
Yellow's my favourite colour.
This is Finn's present.
And this is Lily's present.
Thanks!
Later.
I'm hungry.
We need Chris and Sid's present. It's a birthday cake.
Look! Follow Sid. The cake is in the kitchen.
Okay, did you like the video? It was really funny. What is it? Are they at school? No, it's a birthday party. Okay, so now take your students' books, yes? And open your students' book at page 14, okay? Are you ready? Yes? Okay, take your books and open it at page 14. Ready? Okay. Now I'm going to share with you, yes, the screen. Let's see. Okay. You are here. Yes, page 14. Let's read this together. Number one. Look at this question. Yes, here. What month do you know in English? Yes, what month? ¿Qué son los months? Los meses. What month do you know in English? For example, yes, we have January. Yes, January. What month is January? Yes, January is enero. Yes? Then we have February, March, April, May, June, July, August, September, October, November, and December. Let's see this story again. Yes? Let's go to exercise number one. Yes? There you have. Read and listen to the story. Where are the cake decorations? Yes? Okay. Let's read the story together. Yes, it is the same story as in the video, yes? So now we are going to read it. Can you read with me? ¿Sí? Vamos a ir leyendo juntos. Yo les voy a ir leyendo, ¿sí? La historieta, y ustedes la van a ir leyendo conmigo. Así que tengan los ojos en la historia, ¿sí? In the book. Vayan siguiendo conmigo. Let's see. Hooray! The 3rd of October at last. It's my birthday. Your birthday? It's our birthday. Okay, hooray! It's our birthday. Later, their cake is finished. It's great. Listen, their friends are here. Come on. I think green is my favorite color. Chris, don't touch the cake. Perhaps yellow is my favorite color. This is Finn's present, and this is Lily's present. Thanks. Later, I'm hungry. We need Chris and Sid's present. It's our birthday cake. Look, follow Sid. The cake is in the kitchen. Look at Chris. Her tummy is spotty. I like all the colors. Okay, well, where are they? Yes? They are, yes, in... Yes, Finn's and Lily's house, because it's their birthday, yes? Es el cumpleaños, ¿de quién es? Finn, yes, he is Finn, and Lily, yes? Oh, they are, ¿cómo eran los hermanos mellizos? ¿Cómo se decía? Yes, they are twins, yes, they are twins, brother and sister, twins, as Marty and Tommy. Yes, in our course. Okay, they are twins. So it's their birthday, yes? And it's their birthday party. Have a look at this. Who are they? This is a snake and the name of the snake is Sid, yes? And she is... What is her name? It's Chris. Yes, okay, so we have Sid and Chris. Let's see, what happens here? Yes, Sid and Chris made a cake for them. Yes, ellos hicieron la torta, yes, they make the cake. And they decorated the cake, yes, y la decoraron. And what happens here? They are playing football in the garden, but... This boy, yes, who is he? Finn. Finn is hungry. Yes, do you remember? I'm hungry. I want something to eat. Yes, so Finn feels hungry. So what did they do? They go, yes, to eat the cake. But when they get there, cuando llegan adentro, ¿qué pasó? ¿Qué vieron? Yes, Chris. Yes, has eaten some parts of the cake. ¿Sí? Chris ya se había comido algunas partes de la torta. Yes, different colors. ¿Sí? Se había comido confites de diferentes colores. And now, ¿sí? Y ahora, como es un camaleón, do you know that they get different colors? ¿Sí? Que pueden cambiar de color. Well, Chris cambió de muchos colores. So, let's go to exercise B. Yes, page 14. Exercise B. Yes? Are you there? Good. Read the story again. Yes? We have already read it. ¿Sí? Ya la volvimos a leer. Are the sentences true or false? Correct the false sentences. ¿Sí? We have true and false sentences. ¿Sí? Y tenemos que ver si son verdaderas o falsas. Y después corregirlas. Sentence number one. Have a look at this. Finn is happy. Let's see. Vamos al principio de la historia. This is Finn. Finn is happy. Is it true or false? ¿Esta oración es verdadera o falsa? True or false? Is Finn happy? Think, think, think. Have a look at the picture. Is Finn happy? Let's see. True or false? Yes, it's true. Very good. Finn is really happy. See, it's his birthday. Es su cumpleaños. Está super feliz. Aren't you? Are you happy? Yes? Okay. Cuando es su cumpleaños, ¿no se sienten así de felices? Yes. I'm really happy when my birthday. Yes? Good. Sentence number two. Pictures of Lily and Finn are on the birthday cake. Yes? Pictures of Lily and Finn are on. Do you remember on? ¿Sí? Arriba, yes? Pictures of Lily and Finn are on the birthday cake. Is this sentence true or false? A ver, busquemos en el libro. Fíjense. Is there any picture? ¿Hay alguna imagen arriba de la torta ahí? What do you think? Sentence number two. Is it true or false? True or false? Let's see. It's false. Very good. It's false. Okay, let's go to sentence number three. Chris' favorite color is green. Chris' favorite color is green. Let's see. ¿Dónde dice Chris about his favorite color? ¿Dónde dice Chris sobre su color? Let's see here. I think green is my favorite color. So, the sentence can be true. Entonces la oración es verdadera. But let's see, let's continue reading. Perhaps yellow is my favorite color. So, what do you think about this sentence? Chris' favorite color is green. Is it true or false? First, primero, ¿sí? Dijo que era green. And then, yellow. So, is this sentence true or false? It's false. Very good. It's false. Sentence number four. Some friends are at the door. Some friends are at the door. Okay, let's see. Have a look at this. Como era el cumpleaños de Finn and Lily, yes, los amigos fueron a visitarlos. Are they at the door? ¿Están ellos en la puerta, los amigos? Let's see. Look at this picture. This is Finn's present and this is Lily's present. Think, are they friends? Yes, they are Lily's and Finn's friends. So, some friends are at the door. True or false? Yes, it is true. Yes? Let's go to sentence number five. The children are hungry. Yes? The children are hungry. ¿Qué quiere decir esto? Que los chicos, ¿cómo estaban? Tenían que... Hungry. They want something to eat. Yes? Tienen hambre. Let's see if this sentence is true or false. The children are hungry. A ver, let's see. They are playing in the garden and Finn says, I'm hungry. We need Chris and Sid's present. It's our birthday cake. So, are they hungry? Yes, they are hungry. So, the sentence is true. Very good. Let's go to sentence number six. The children follow mom. What is to follow? Follow, yes, is to walk behind someone. Yes, es caminar atrás de alguien, perseguir, seguir. ¿Sí? So the children follow mom. Let's see. They go to the kitchen to eat the cake. Did Do they follow Mum? Let's see. A ver. Siguieron a Mum. Is this Mum? I think its name is Sid. Sí, me parece que el nombre es Sid. So, do they follow Mum? The children follow Mum. True or false? Sorry. True or false? True or false? It's false. They follow Sid. Fíjense lo que dice. Look, follow Sid. The cake is in the kitchen. Sí, vamos a seguirlo a Sid porque la torta está en la cocina. Sentence number 7. The last one. Yes? Sid is angry with Chris. Sid is angry with Chris. Have a look at Sid. Sid is angry. La oración dice que Sid is angry. Is Sid angry with Chris? Let's see the picture. ¿Está enojado Sid with Chris? What do you think? Look at its face. Mírenle la cara. Is Sid angry with Chris? Yes, absolutely. Yes, he is really, really angry with Chris. Yes, está re enojado porque se había comido todos los confites de la torta. Okay, very good. Okay, well, could you do the exercise? ¿Pudieron hacer el ejercicio? ¿Sí? ¿Entendieron las oraciones? Perfect. Okay, now let's go to page number 15. Page 15, the next page. Yes, the following one. ¿Sí? La que sigue de la historia. Okay, I'm going to share with you the screen again. Yes, so we can continue reading. Okay, great. Let's see. Vocabulary. Put the dates in the correct order. Yes? You have to look at all these dates. Sí, son muchas fechas. And we have to put them in order. Y las tenemos que poner en orden. ¿Cuál es el primer mes del año? The first month is January. Yes? So, have a look at this. January, enero, es el primer mes del año. A ver si les sale poner los demás en orden. What you can do, lo que pueden hacer es write the number, ¿sí? Escriban el número arriba, ¿sí? De la fecha. For example, yes? Por ejemplo, ponemos arriba de 1st of January, que ya sabemos que es el primero de enero, escribimos number one. ¿Sí? ¿Qué me sigue después de January? January, enero, febrero, so it's similar to February. Have a look at this, the 2nd of February. Entonces escriben arriba de febrero el number 2. Okay? Well, I'm going to give you 1 minute to do this activity. Okay? And then we correct. So, let's see. You have 1 minute to finish this activity. ¿Sí? Les doy un minutito para que pongan arriba de cada uno. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. ¿Sí? Hay que poner las fechas en orden. ¿Ok? Are you ready? ¿Ok? Well, let's try to do it. Go! Okay, how are you doing? Good. ¿Están pudiendo poner las fechas en orden? Okay, let's see if you could finish. Vamos a ver si pudieron terminar. Okay. Ready? 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, let's see. Okay, here, yes, you have the screen. Let's analyze this. Mm-hmm. We have 1st of January, number 1. Number 2, 2nd of February. Well, now you are going to listen and check your answers, okay? You are going to listen and check your answers. Let's see. Okay, let's check the activity, okay? Listen.
Track 25, page 15, exercise 2.
The 1st of January. The 2nd of February. The 3rd of March. The 4th of April. The 5th of May. The 20th of June. The 21st of July. The 22nd of August. The 23rd of September. The 26th of October. The 27th of November. The 31st of December.
Is it correct? Do you want to listen to the audio again? Yes. Okay, let's listen to the audio again.
Track 25, page 15, exercise 2.
The 1st of January. The 2nd of February. The 3rd of March. The 4th of April. The 5th of May. The 20th of June. The 21st of July. The 22nd of August. The 23rd of September. The 26th of October. The 27th of November. The 31st of December.
Okay, so now that you have corrected, yes, the exercise, let's analyze this date, yes? ¿Saben cómo se dicen? ¿Se acuerdan que nosotros siempre escribíamos la fecha en el pizarrón y ustedes me preguntaban, teacher, ¿por qué va con ND hoy? ¿Por qué va con TH otros días? ¿Sí? Esos números se llaman ordinal numbers. Tenemos cardinal numbers, los números cardinales, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 100, ¿yes? And then we have ordinal numbers. Son los números que se usan para las fechas, por ejemplo, ¿sí? Entonces nosotros tenemos el número 1, pero el número ordinal es first, que significa primero, ¿sí? Fíjense que nosotros en español también usamos, es el primero de abril, ¿sí? Bien, o cuando entregamos premios, ¿sí? Primer lugar ocupado por segundo, no decimos dos, decimos segundo, tercero, ¿sí? Well, in English, it's the same, ¿sí? En inglés pasa lo mismo, se dicen de otra manera. Fíjense, exercise C. Now say the dates in the correct order, ¿yes? First, second, third are called ordinal numbers. Todos estos números, ¿sí? Estos y los que están acá arriba y muchos más, ¿sí? Se llaman números ordinales, ¿sí? Cuando nosotros decimos cuándo es nuestro cumpleaños, usamos números ordinales, ¿sí? Dice exercise 3. Ask your friend about their birthday. How many people have the same birthday month as you? ¿Cuántos más de nosotros cumplimos los años el mismo mes? Después, cuando tengamos la clase, nos preguntamos entre todos, ¿sí? Mientras tanto, vamos a ir practicando cómo se dicen estas fechas de cumpleaños, ¿sí? Entonces, for example, when is your birthday, teacher Laura? Yes, my birthday is the 19th of October, ¿sí? Mi cumpleaños es el 19 de octubre, pero yo no digo 19 solo, ¿sí? Que sería el número 19, digo 19th. ¿Sí? A partir del número 4 para arriba, al número le sumo la TH. Entonces tenemos First, second, third. Uno, dos y tres, ¿sí? Primero, segundo y tercero. Pero a partir del cuatro sería fourth, th, y suena como una z, fourth. Fifth, sixth, seventh, eighth, yes, ninth, tenth. ¿Cómo se dicen las fechas? Fíjense, my birthday is the 19th of October, ¿sí? Digo el número ordinal, yes, 19th of October, ¿sí? La idea es que nosotros practiquemos hoy un poquito, ¿sí? Practicando un poquito decir cómo es la fecha de su cumpleaños. Igualmente, no se preocupen, que la próxima clase lo practicamos entre todos, ¿sí? Vamos a practicar cómo se escriben los números ordinales, ¿sí? Cómo se escriben y cómo se pronuncian. Y lo vamos a practicar entre todos, ¿sí? So don't worry, ¿yes? Now I want to tell you that I'm going to upload, ¿sí? Voy a compartirles en Google Classroom el Kahoot. ¿Cómo lo van a hacer? ¿Sí? En el Kahoot lo que vamos a practicar es el uso del verb to be. ¿Se acuerdan el uso del verb to be? Que tenía tres formas, que vimos el video en el que hablaba Paula. ¿Sí? Acuérdense. The verb to be has three forms. ¿Sí? El verbo to be tiene tres formas. Am, is y are. ¿Sí? Cuando yo hablo de I sobre mí, digo I am. No digo I is. No, no, no. I am. Cuando mi sujeto es he o she, ¿sí? Una nena, un nene, una mujer, un hombre, ¿sí? He or she, no digo she are, no digo she am, digo she is o he is, ¿sí? Y cuando mi sujeto es we, que era nosotros, ¿se acuerdan? We, o they, que significa ellos, o you, ¿sí? El verbo to be que uso es are, you are. So, for example, I am your teacher. ¿Sí? I am your teacher. I can say, for example, have a look at this. She is mom. She is mom. Yes? Or we can say, they are twins. They are twins. Yes? So let's revise. Revisamos rápido. I se usa con am. I am o I am not. Is se usa con he or she. Yes? Para nene o nena singular, uno solo. ¿Sí? He is o he isn't, que sería la forma negativa. Y después, are se usa con you, we o they. ¿Sí? Are o aren't. Este video está subido en Google Classroom, ¿sí? Así que si quieren lo pueden buscar y lo pueden mirar de ahí para volver a recordar. Después de mirar ese videito, pueden jugar el Kahoot que yo les voy a dejar guardado en Google Classroom, ¿ok? Bueno, espero que hayan entendido todo, ¿sí? And, me estoy olvidando algo importante, homework, ¿sí? Vamos a hacer una tareita muy cortita from the workbook. ¿Sí? Del activity book. ¿Sí? El que es blanco y negro. Black and white. You have to do. Yes, here. Page. Number six. Page six. Exercise number one. Yes? Page six. Exercise number one. Okay? And. ¿Sí? And. You have to do, yes, you have to finish exercise 1 and 2, page number 4. Esto ya lo hicimos algunos en clase. El que no lo pudo hacer o no pudo terminarlo todo completo, completa exercise 1 and exercise 2, ¿ok? Bueno, eso sería todo. Yo ahora igualmente se los escribo, así no se olvidan, ¿sí? Y nos volvemos a ver next class, yes, see you next class. Bye. Have a nice weekend.